In this previous video, linked in the card above, I showed you how to auto-generate subtitles for your videos, but that involved two softwares, Audacity and DaVinci Resolve. Now, thanks to Tom Moroney, you can auto-generate subtitles inside the free version of DaVinci Resolve for free. Let me show you how. Go to the link in the description and download the respective AutoSub installer for your operating system. I'll download for Windows. Double-click the downloaded file. You may get this warning from Windows Defender. If you're extra paranoid, and you should be, then go through the source code in the GitHub page before deciding whether or not to run the file. Click More Info and then click Run anyway. Follow the installation instructions. Once it's installed, go back to your project in Resolve. Before you generate the subtitles, you need to mark the area you want to transcribe. So click I on the keyboard to mark your endpoint, and click O to mark your outpoint. Oh, if you haven't already, please first set up AutoSubs. It makes it faster to run transcriptions on subsequent runs. Go to Workspace, Scripts, AutoSubs. Select the audio to be transcribed. Mine is Audio 1. Select your input language. There's plenty to choose from. I'll go with English. Next, select your AI model. Now, what you choose here will depend on your hardware setup, so choose accordingly. I found that the large model V3 balances speed and accuracy and works well on low-end systems, meaning GPU VRAM of 6 GB or less. I'll select large. For the text formatting options, I'll leave them as default for now and set them on a project-to-project basis. Okay, click Finish, and we shall return here, so close these two. Next thing you need to do is create a subtitle template. Go to Effects, Titles, and drag in a text plus title onto a new video track. Name the track Subtitles or any other descriptive name. Customize your subtitle as you wish. That is, change the font, color, all that. This one I'll give it a drop shadow. Then position a subtitle, like down here. Good. Once you're done creating the template, then go back to the media pool and drag this text plus title and drop it there. Again, give it a descriptive name, custom subtitle text. This is a template the script will use, and it will place the subtitles on this track. You can now delete the text plus title from the timeline. Go to Workspace, Scripts, AutoSubs. Select the audio track to be transcribed. I only have one audio track in this case. Select the output track for the subtitles. Subtitles. Then select the custom template we created earlier. There are many settings here that you can customize, so go through each of them and adjust accordingly. Though one I would suggest changing is the subtitle line rules. Character count is the maximum characters per line. Word count is how many words per line. Adjust according to the type of dialogue you have. I'll set mine to 4 words per line. You can also have multiple lines and also choose to split on punctuation. That's done, so click Start Transcription. The plugin will first export the audio. This causes a small issue, but more on that later on. Next, it will download the AI model you had selected, large version 3 in my case, though this is just a one-time download. Then the transcription process will start. How long it takes, again, will depend on your hardware. Once it's done, click Add to Timeline. Actually, you should also make sure you go through the whole transcription and edit any mistakes. And here are your subtitles. Let's give it a listen. Audio normalization is where you add a constant amount of gain to your audio to bring the amplitude to a target level, the norm. Looks good. Next step is to export the SRT file that you can upload to YouTube. Back on the AutoSubs application, click Import Export. Click on Export. SRT is chosen by default. Click Download SRT and save it to your preferred location. Few minor issues I noted. 1. It didn't add the subtitles to the track I'd specified earlier, but maybe this was user error. I don't know. 2. The audio file that was initially rendered out is not deleted when the transcription is done, or I'm not seeing a setting to clear this on exit. The third issue, when the plugin first exports the audio only, it doesn't restore your original project's export settings. So when you go to render your finished video, you will find that the render settings have changed, and thus you have to reconfigure them. Two ways to solve this. 1. Save your render settings as presets, so that you can reload them whenever needed. 2. is to create a new project, say called Subtitles, specifically for generating subtitles. Then you can copy the subtitles from this project. Anyway, as I said, these are minor issues for a free plugin, so feel free to check it out. In my next video, I'll show you another plugin that has really enhanced my color grading workflow. Subscribe if you do not want to miss that one. Thanks for watching, and thanks again to Tom Moroney for offering this software for free. And until the next one, lights out.